Hello and welcome to The Teacher's Room, the show that's by teachers for teachers. I'm Dem.
And I'm Sian, and this episode's topic is...
These days, with access to the internet and smartphones, it's even easier for teachers to get video into the classroom as a learning resource.
Exactly, but don't just play the whole video for the students to watch.
It's cheating.
Yeah, get a clip and then use it to develop students' speaking skills,
vocabulary,
listening skills,
pronunciation,
language.
Loads of stuff. Trailers are clips which are used to advertise a movie, and they're great for short, focused activities in the classroom.
Yeah, so play the trailer and get students to predict the story of the film, talk about the relationship between the characters, or even write the ending.
Exactly, and don't forget to get them to talk about whether or not they'd actually like to see the movie. Something else you can do with trailers is use them to talk about and teach relative clauses. For example, he's a character who, it's a place where, it's a thing which. This year.
Hello, class. Hang on, where have all the English books gone?
In a classroom near you.
Give us back the books!
This lady.
Hello.
And this guy.
Hello.
Will teach you English.
Get down!
No, he's dead! I've got the books!
Yes! Mission accomplished.
Coming soon.
The nice thing about video is it's not only a picture, but sound too. So why not cover up the picture and have the students listen to the clip?
Yes, and then based on what they hear, they have to decide what is happening on the screen.
Exactly.
So this is very good for
sound vocabulary. It's good for generating interest before doing a full detailed listening. It's good for modal verbs of deduction. It works very, very well if you have a clip which is minimal on dialogue, has lots of sound effects and a little bit of action.
Ah, okay. Someone's walking and knocking. They must be walking into a house and knocking at the door.
Good idea. Oh, they're talking. Maybe they're talking to the house owner.
Yeah. What is that? Monster? Tiger. There's a tiger in the house.
The tiger killed everybody.
You could also remove the sound, so play the video on silent.
Yeah. This is really, really good to get students to work together in groups and write the dialogues for the missing sound. Then you can have them read the dialogue over the top of the video like a dub.
Or you can get students to sit facing each other, so one student can see the screen, the other student can't. The student that can see has to describe everything that's happening. Mm. This is great for speaking fluency, vocab,
present continuous.
Mm. Okay, Dan, there's a kind of zoo and there's a donkey and the donkey... Oh, the donkey's flying. The donkey's going up in the air and he's... he's falling. No, he's... So, if you have a clip on using video or anything else in the classroom, send it to us.
Yeah, you might get one of these awesome t-shirts. Where do they go to find out how to send it to us?
bbclearningenglish.com.
That's bbclearningenglish.com.
Let's go and watch the end of our
film. Let's go finish the film. Right, bye guys.
See ya.